Because in this video, we are going to see about the del tree function, which again calls three other functions, case A, case B, case C, which are nothing but if there is a leaf node or if there is a node with a one child, if it is going to be a node with a two child, how we are going to del it. So for that, we have written different functions, separate functions. But this function, in general, it calls the calls these functions. So here, del tree, in this what we are doing is, first we are checking, we are having the, we are passing the value, which is to be deleted from the tree. Now, this returns the location and the parent of that particular node. So here, what we do is, root equal to null, we are checking. That is, if root equal to null, then the tree is empty. So what we are doing, so we cannot delete anything, because to delete something, there must be a node. So first we are checking whether root equal to null. If it is null, then we say tree is empty, then return. Else we execute the search algorithm where we pass that value, and then this will return the its parent. The element will be searched and the node will be found. That location will be returned in this pointer, and its parent will be return in this pointer. Then this will return a 1 if that element is present in the tree, else it returns a 0. So if it returns a 0, it say item is not present in tree and we return. Else what we doing is, location left, we check whether it is a single child or no child, etc. So for that, how you can do, as I said, this location pointer, it points to the node which we are going to delete. So first we check whether the pointer is having that location left is equal to null and location right is equal to null, in which case it is a leaf node. So for example, if you take this here, let me take the, yes, let us take this tree. Here, suppose I am going to delete this tree, then what happens? This will be the location and this will be the parent returned by the searching algorithm. So what we have done there is, we are checking whether the location left is equal to null and location right equal to null, which means this is a leaf node. When both the pointer, left and right pointer of a particular node is null, then we say that is a root node. So that is a leaf node, sorry. So that is what here we say. So in that case, we call this algorithm case_A. Which we consider as a no child, leaf node. Then we pass the pointer. So this algorithm will take care of manipulating and removing that particular leaf node. Then we check if location left is not equal to null and location right is equal to null. That is whether it is a right child we are checking. So if location left is not equal to null means, there is some more, if location left is not equal to null and location right is equal to null means, say here, let us consider, yes, we are going to, let us consider the one child. Here there is no single child. This also has two child, this also has two child. So now let me take one more value here. Okay. Now, so let us say, since it is a right, let me take this as a right child, and which means it must be greater than this 100. So here let me give 110. Okay. Let us store this value, and this will be the leaf node of this. That is, let me imagine we are going to delete this node. That is a node with a single child, only one child, in which case you have to check whether that is location will be returned by location will be this and its parent will be this, because we are going to delete this node. This node has only one children, and how you are going to, because if you remove this, this child should not be lost. It should be made to point to this. Okay, so it will be made to point to this. So how you can do? So for that, but first you have to check whether this child is a left child or a right child of this node. So that is what we are doing that. If location right is not equal to null, then means this is a right child. But if it is not equal to null, left is not equal to null, then it will be a left child. That is what here we are doing. See here, if location left is not equal to null and location right equal to null, in right there is no children, but in left this the children is present in a left. Then so we call the case B and we pass this document. If location left is equal to null and location right is equal to not null, mean the child is a right child. Again in the case we call the same algorithm, we have found that it is a right child and we pass the argument. Then if location left is not equal to null and location right is also not equal to null, which means it has two children. So for example, I am going to delete this, which means this is also not equal to null, this is also not equal to null. So you are going to remove this, means how you are going to manipulate these two, so that if you remove this, this should not be removed from the tree. They have to be modified in such a way that they will be again linked with the tree. That is what. So if you are deleting a node, the care should be taken that the other subtree, the child of that particular node, should not be removed from the tree. So that is why there are three cases we are considering: whether the node which you are going to delete has no children. Say for example this, whether it is a leaf node or it has a single child. This is the node which we are going to remove, means it has only one child. So we have to find whether this child is a left child or a right child, and then accordingly we have to modify the pointer to point to this. Then if it has a two children, so I am going to remove this node, means it has two children. So how are you going to handle this situation? So that we will be seeing in the case A, case B and case C algorithm.